a toxic algae bloom is wreaking havoc on sea life across the West Coast. Nick Denezzo joins us from SeaWorld to talk about the impact that we're seeing here in San Diego. Nick, good to have you on this morning. Thanks for taking the time.
Hi, yeah, thanks for having me on today.
Yeah, so can I ask you about this? So this algae poisoning, can you talk a little bit about what it is? Because we're seeing so many of these cases.
Yeah, so we're seeing a very significant algae bloom right now. It's a specific type of algae that actually releases a neurotoxin. And so what we're seeing is a lot of animals that are getting sick because of the toxin that's produced by the algae that's blooming out there right now.
And we're talking from birds to sea lions, correct?
Yeah, this primarily focuses on marine mammals and seabirds. So we're seeing sea lions, the occasional dolphin, and a mix of different bird species.
Now, I understand SeaWorld has cared for about 35 sea lions and 15 birds. Is that a large number for the animal care team?
It's not a dramatically huge number right off the bat, but the crazy thing for us is it's been a huge increase just in a very short span of time. Mm. Most of those cases we picked up in the last roughly 2 weeks, and so it's been a huge increase in the amount of animals in our care all at that same time.
You know, we know, Nick, that lifeguards have been warning some families and just people in general to be aware of these, the sick sea lions should they come across them. Can you talk a little bit about that and you know, what some folks might do in case they ever come across, you know, a sea creature that might look sick?
Yeah, so as I mentioned, this is producing a neurotoxin. So this algae is actually damaging the brains of some of these animals. And part of what we're going to see is a lot of disoriented behavior, potentially seizures, but we also want to make sure people are being safe because these animals could become hyper-aggressive. Mm. So the part of this brain that it's affecting could affect navigation, but also some of their emotional regulation. They can be very unpredictable animals.
Do you know if humans can get sick from this at all?
Only if you're eating seafood. So these animals aren't getting sick directly from the water. They're getting sick because of the food that they're eating out there. So it's accumulating in the food chain by the fish and the shellfish. And these animals that are eating big quantities of fish are what's making them sick.
Yeah, you know, we just saw some impressive video there of, the animal care team, SeaWorld, doing what you guys do best. And that is, you know, obviously care for marine life. These images that we're showing our friends at home. I guess the best rule for or guidance for people who are out along the coast is not to approach or not to touch these animals, right?
Yeah, we definitely recommend people keep their distance. As I mentioned, they can be very unpredictable animals and they are sick right now. They could carry a host of different bacteria and illnesses. And we have a hotline that anybody can call 24/7, 365 days a year. So if you see something, bring down as much info as you can, try to get some photos or videos if possible, and give us a call so we know where that animal is located.
Oh, that's good to know so that they can, that hotline number, we'll get that out there for sure. I wanted to ask you about what ends up happening to these animals that you guys are caring for. Do they, or some of them, like the sea lions, get released back into the ocean?
Yeah, so this toxin could have roughly like 50 to 65% success rate in their treatment. So we do see some of them recovering. We're actually returning a few of them out there today. So there's a couple of them that have recovered fully and are going to be going back out this morning.
Oh, wow.
But then there are some other ones that we're still picking up that are in pretty severe condition.
Fantastic. Well, Nick, thank you and your team for doing what you guys do best, the SeaWorld Animal Rescue Team. And we appreciate you taking the time and we'll, you know, follow this because, who knows how long this algae is going to be around, but we'll be monitoring it. Thank you, Nick, for your time. And for more information,
go to
our website. Yeah, fox5sandiego.com and click on the CNN tab. We'll be back.